It is every passenger's worst nightmare. The pilot comes on the loudspeaker and announces, "This is your captain.
Brace for impact."
This is what happened 11 years ago in New York, in Hudson River, when US Airways flight 1549 struck a flock of geese shortly after taking off New York's LaGuardia Airport, causing the airplane lose all engine power. The aircraft was Airbus A320 from New York's LaGuardia Airport. According to officials and passengers, everyone on board was accounted for and alive. For the ones who had a chance to visit New York, has a knowledge of Hudson River. So ditching into a lake or an ocean has been quite intriguing topic amongst pilots and amongst people. So why not to talk about, why not to shed some light on ditching today? Let's get started. So before getting into the subject, don't forget to follow me on other social media accounts as well. In basic terms, when ditching comes to my mind, I remember six items, which we will talk about one by one. So number one, sending distress signals. Transmit mayday, speed, course, altitude, current position, situation, intention, time, and position of the intended touchdown and type of the airplane using existing air-to-ground frequency. Set transponder code 7700 and, if practical, determine the nearest course to the landfall or to the nearest ship. Guys, the second step is advising cabin crew and passengers. Alert the cabin crew and passengers to prepare for ditching. This is quite important and crucial part. As you predict, no one wants to ditch, right? Assign life raft positions and order all loose equipment in the airplane secured. Put on life vests, shoulder harnesses, and seat belts. Don't inflate the life vests until after exiting the airplane. This is quite crucial. So tip number three, we need to ditch, right? We have some kind of an emergency and we need to ditch as soon as possible. So there might be some kind of damage while ditching. So the good thing to do is fuel burn off. Guys, tip number three, if we have an emergency requiring immediate touchdown into the ocean or a lake, what I want to give you as a suggestion is burning your fuel, as you may predict. This is tip number three. Consider burning off fuel prior to ditching if the situation permits. This provides greater buoyancy and a lower approach speed. However, don't reduce the fuel to a critical amount, as ditching with engine thrust available improves the ability to properly control touchdown. So tip number four, this is quite important as well. Passenger cabin preparation. Confer with cabin personnel either by interphone or by having them report to the flight deck in person to ensure passenger cabin preparation for ditching are complete. So number five, ditching final. When it comes to ditching on final, transmit final position. Select landing flaps for the existing condition for ditching. Don't forget to advise your cabin crew of an imminent touchdown. On final approach, announcing ditching is imminent and advise cabin crew and passengers to brace for impact. Maintain airspeed at VREF. Try to lower your rate of descent to minimum, maintaining 200 or 300 feet per minute rate of descent is enough. Plan to touchdown on the windward side and parallel to the waves of swells, if practical. To accomplish the flare and touchdown, rotate smoothly to the touchdown attitude of 10 degrees to 12 degrees. And don't forget to maintain airspeed and your rate of descent with thrust. The last step is the most intriguing one, initiating an evacuation. After the airplane has come to rest, proceed to assigned ditching stations and deploy slides, rafts, evacuate as soon as possible, ensuring all passengers are out of the airplane. Be careful not to rip or puncture the slides and rafts. Avoid drifting into or under the parts of the airplane. Remain clear of fuel-saturated water. Also, I would like to pass some information and shed some light on official findings. So guys, dying after ditching is quite rare. In extremely cold water can cause pain, uncontrollable gasp, hyperventilation, changes in heart rate may be cause of many unexplained sudden disappearances.